It is beautiful here. Must be one of the offshore islands. Coco's one of the Cinco Muertes, maybe.
Huh. 8 left.
Huh. Heavier than I thought.
Huh. Huh. Keep it steady.
Maybe if there's a phone line or a radio. Engine. Some kind of... Wait. International Genetic Technologies. That was the company from the dinosaur trial. After the trial, that old guy, John Hammond, wrote a book. He said it was somewhere in Central America.
My name is John Parker Hammond. I was born on March 14th, 1928.
Oh no. Oh God. This is Site B. This is John Hammond's Lost World. There must have been something in the memoir.
A Nobel Prize or a financial empire waits somewhere in a darkened room, in a dirty, derelict building, somewhere in the Pacific.
He really did it.
Brachiosaur. Oldest of our recreations by 50 million years. The only true Jurassic native.
So that's what that feels like. I knew all along this was a stupid idea. I'm probably out drinking right now. And who?
The technology, the real trick of it, is still in there. In a darkened room, in an empty building with a dirty floor. It waits. The flashpoint. The origin of Jurassic Park. A forest this wild, this unknown, has not been seen by any human since the great hunters of the early Pliocene. Velociraptor, a small theropod native to China and Mongolia. Pack hunter, quite vicious and quite intelligent.
This was the place. This used to be just an urban myth.
An idea brought me awake one morning in New York. I almost didn't write it down. What if a mosquito sucked the blood of a dinosaur 100 million years ago? The insect is then covered in tree sap, which, over the millennia, becomes amber. The insect is preserved perfectly. But you see, and here's the clever part, wouldn't the dinosaur blood be preserved as well? The blood holds DNA, a tiny spiral of genetic code. Abracadabra. Sunlight angled down through the dusty air in Norman's office, and I leaned against a solid oak table as I outline my plans for International Genetic Technologies. It was the flowering of an ambition born 50 years ago. 50 years struggle come to this.
Ha ha ha!
Six rounds.
I stumbled out of the helicopter, already beginning to sweat, and looked around at the lush forest, the wet leaves, the first task was genetic recovery, acquiring Jurassic or Cretaceous amber, extracting preserved DNA, and reassembling the complete sequences, bringing it up the well, we called it. Three Cray XMPs move more data faster than any computer center in the Americas. In 11 months, Site B became the most powerful genetics facility in the world.
Whatever.
Of species, the history of life on Earth is being methodically reversed. I spared no expense, permitted no failures. By 1983, we held 13 new patents.
I was in high school then.
November 1983, test fertilization of an artificial ovum. My hands shook as I held the tiny eyedropper. One drop. Two drops. There. The genie was out of the bottle. The rapid doctor took shape inside its egg and I watched it on the ultrasound monitor. It looked like a ghost or a puff of smoke. I began to have my first inkling of the seriousness of our work. How deep the well was. This was life from 65 or 100 million years before mankind.
I've really done it. This is not a normal situation.
Tyrannus horus rex. Tyrant lizard. They reigned for 25 million years. We grew seven of them. The seven rulers of the island. jungle canopy hung over us. There was an utter silence. Far away I could hear a Jeep engine idling. We released the first raptor on April 22nd, 1985. It wandered back and forth near the wall for 4 minutes and 22 seconds before hearing a noise which drew it further off into the brush. By 1987, the first of them had reached full size. The ecosystem of another era began to reassert itself. In the jungle, the forest, and the mountain, three raptor tribes staked out territory. Albatrosaurs and 7 T-Rex chose their dominions. Uneasy borders drawn around forest ridges and ponds. Not all the original species survived. In the end, only a few adjusted to the new world. These became dominant.
Showers, coffee, air conditioning, almost there.
main harbor for Site B. Main laboratory and administrative buildings. This was where we made our discovery, where the real magic trick happened. When they come to dig up our secrets, they'll come here. The forest smelled of wet leaves, damp earth, rotting wood. When I was... The forest smelled of wet leaves, damp earth, rotting wood. When I was little, I dreamed of a time when the entire world was covered by an ancient forest. Great hunters stalked in the cool darkness among silent, huge columnar trees, oaks and sequoias.
can smell the ocean. Dinosaur Park. What a great idea.
followed a scheme I only vaguely understood, marking seasons and the lunar year and the movement of the stars.
Huh?
Feels full.
October 1996. The InGen Corporation is taken out of my hands by a vote of the Board of Directors. My nephew dispatches his team.
Feels full.
I'm sure you've heard the rest of the story on the television news or in the tabloids.
Hasn't been used.
In 1989, the park was nearly complete. Our investors demanded on-site approval, and I, idiotically as it now turned out, believed we were ready.
I bet you can see all the way to Costa Rica or Panama.
Investment strategies and profit. I stood apart, master of codes and lost worlds of heat and cold, and the sleep of 100 million years. My work lies where I left it. If there was anyone brave enough and clever enough to take it and return the keys to time. Foundation of a new empire. On October the 3rd, 1989, I sat on a wooden bench in the waiting room in Washington, D.C. A government panel put me on the stand. As my name was read out, the session room went silent. Mighty Clan, who said, Two vast and trunkless legs of stone stand in the desert. Near them, on the sand, half-sunk a shattered visage lies, whose frown and wrinkled lip and sneer of cold command tell that its sculptor well those passions read which yet survive. Step.